Stroke of Fate is a third-person point-and-click adventure game developed by the Russian studio SP-Line and published by Akella in 2009. It comes in two separate games, which together consist of three parts: Operation Valkyrie, Operation Adlerhorst, and Operation Bunker. The games are available on Steam, where they have received mixed reviews. A Stroke of Fate, Operation Valkyrie, is set in Germany in July 1944, at the peak of World War II. SS-Standartenführer Gerhard Detlef Mayer, a high-ranking official of the Gestapo, is getting more and more disillusioned by Adolf Hitler's regime. The Soviets are approaching Berlin, the defeat of Germany is inevitable. Yet Hitler wants to continue fighting till the bitter end, even if that meant the complete devastation of Germany. After having witnessed what is going on in the concentration camps, one thing becomes clear for Mayer: Hitler has to die.
His horrible orders doomed many thousands of loyal soldiers to certain and meaningless death. In 1944, when the Soviets took Minsk, I made the final decision. The devil had brought war to the world and was decimating his own people, and this devil had to die. I decided that I must rid the world of Adolf Hitler.
After several failed attempts to assassinate the Führer, the Gestapo is determined to find and punish the traitors. Mayer is assigned a case to uncover a circle of conspirators against the regime. Instead, Mayer joins the resistance, using his position to put the Gestapo off the scent. After the failed Operation Valkyrie from July 20, 1944, Hitler seeks refuge in his headquarters, Castle Adlerhorst.
With some effort, I persuaded Mueller to appoint me to Adlerhorst as inspector of the castle guard. It's an easy assignment, especially compared with the true task before me.
In the second part of the first game, Mayer sees another opportunity for an assassination in the south of Germany. The second game, Operation Bunker, which came out a bit later, takes place in Berlin in April 1945, in the very end of World War II.
Прошло три месяца. Наступила весна 1945 года. Советские войска уже были в Берлине, а фюрер заперся в бункере под рейхсканцелярией и вместо того, чтобы капитулировать, продолжал посылать на бессмысленную смерть преданных ему солдат.
Gerhard Mayer continues with his venture to kill Hitler in the Führerbunker. The Stroke of Fate games are 2.5D adventures with gorgeous background graphics. I especially like the love for details of the historical setting. Many of the characters you meet during your adventure are based on real people. In the options, the player can choose to play the game in color, in black and white, or in sepia. The inventory can be found on top of the screen. The mouse mechanics are left click for interaction and right click for look at. Most of the negative reviews of both games often mention the quality of the English voiceovers.
Herr Mayer, perhaps we can leave this issue until the peace comes. Alcohol is the only distraction for many people these days.
You may be right, Wilm, but it makes me uneasy nevertheless.
I really cannot share that view. Mayer may speak in a monotonous voice, but that's exactly what I would expect from a guy who works for the Gestapo. There are some side characters with annoying voices, but overall I cannot recall anything awful. I guess the release of the second game, Operation Bunker, was rushed, as it doesn't feature English voiceovers at all, only Russian ones, which are well made. Subtitles are available in English.
Пачка почти полная. В последнее время меня совсем не тянет курить. Мне нужно найти дверь, к которой подходит этот ключ, и открыть ее.
The main character moves very slowly. There is unfortunately no running option. Gladly, with a double click, you can switch rooms immediately, and in the bottom right corner you can access a map for fast traveling, which comes in quite handy, as Mayer has to visit his house several times to switch between his uniform and civilian clothes. The Gestapo man also carries a diary with helpful hints for what to do next, in case you get stuck. The overall difficulty is intermediate, most of the puzzles are quite logical. During a playthrough of A Stroke of Fate, you will encounter several mini-games, like deciphering a message, playing a round of poker,
my good men, I believe I shall raise,
or eluding searchlights. All in all, A Stroke of Fate is a real bleak game. The developers have put an emphasis on authenticity rather than on action or drama. Despite all its flaws, A Stroke of Fate is an ambitious project which perfectly manages to capture the atmosphere of the beginning of the end of the Third Reich.
So we meet again, Mayer. How has life been treating you? Quite well, actually. You don't look so sure about that.